I'm so bad with the names. What's his face? Was it Wanderlei Silva? He got knocked out by this dude with red hair and in 27 fucking seconds. And after the dude with the red hair knocked him out, or dyed red hair, you know, he's a spy in my world. he fucking knocks this guy out. And if you see the look on his face when he was flexing after he did it, it was one of the most terrifying things I've ever seen in my life. Once again, you just look at the guy, and as every guy always thinks, every guy has a nightmare of could I survive in prison? That guy does not have that nightmare. That dude, unrapeable. That's the highest level belt that you can get in martial arts.
Anybody who's like, oh, I like boxing better than UFC, you got to see the way he knocked this guy out. If you can't appreciate, he fucking jabs him in the face, and in the moment when he closes his eyes, this guy fucking drops down two floors like a fucking cat, you know, and then punches him in his stomach. And the dude's like, what the fuck? He leans to the right. That guy throws, this fucking cowboy guy throws a left hook. And as his fucking head goes over to the right, he fucking boots him in the face. It was like Matrix level fighting, except it was fucking real. Unbelievable. I couldn't beat a fucking fifth grade girl. I mean, it's so humbling to watch one of these events.
Your wife is in my DMs. Jesus. And Dustin said, yeah, he was grabbing my gloves. He's a dirtbag. I mean, that's the first time I felt like I saw, like, because they usually say all kinds of crazy shit. And then afterwards, they're so nice. That's the only time I can really remember where it sounded like pre-fight hype. Now, either the two of them are the greatest, you know, promoters ever. But I like people going, he went too far. You don't say things about his wife. It's, what the fuck are you talking about? They say all kinds of crazy. Or like, you know, he said he was going to murder me. It's like, well, you didn't say he was going to eat your children. He didn't say he was going to fuck you until you love me. You know, there's a lot much crazier shit has been said than that. He's selling the fight. Masvidal. I'm white. I'm sorry. Okay. Jorge. And he was literally saying, like, I'm going to beat this guy's fucking face. He was on Rogan's podcast, just like, you know. Yeah, he wasn't being funny. He was literally going, I'm going to beat this guy's fucking face in. I fucking hate this guy.
But I don't like this dude, man. Before my alarm goes off, I'm already awake. I want to break his fucking face, man. I want to break his fucking rib cage. And I don't want to knock him out early on. I just want to torture that guy, man. If I get the chance to torture him for 14 minutes and 50 seconds before I stop him, that's what I'm going to do, man. You know, I don't like the dude.
And I don't want to ruin, spoiler alert, I don't want to ruin this 5-second fight. He came out and redefined the right there, Fred. He fucking.
They get. The fight clock is brought to you by Mojo.
Oh!
The fucking, it looked like somebody trying to tackle a car. The fucking bell rings. He just runs full speed right at the guy. And I don't know what the guy was like, I'm going to go for a fucking takedown. And then he also, his head was kind of like, wow, that guy's running really fast. It'd be like trying to tackle somebody on a fucking motor scooter who also is a champion UFC fighter. That's how fast this fucking guy was going. And just jumped in the air, flying knee, and hit this guy right in the side of the head. And this guy, he looked like he had rigor mortis. It was actually scary. And my only thing that I don't like about the UFC is after you're clearly knocked out, you always take another two fucking, you know, really hard punches to the fucking head. I saw that twice last night, but to be honest with you, these guys are so fucking fast. It's only so fast that the ref can get in there. He's trying to stay out of the way, so it wasn't the ref's fault, but Jesus Christ. And then there was the championship fight, which unfortunately, I really should know the guy's name. The guy's like fucking got like a blown out ACL. And he was fighting, that wasn't Jack Johnson, right? Isn't that the fucking guy who writes that? Was originally a boxer, and then it was somehow a white guy with a guitar. Who's Jack Johnson? Yeah, that's a white guy with a guitar. And he's all, he sings those songs like ba da ba. He says you just start singing along.
Well, I was sitting, waiting, wishing you believed in superstitions. Then maybe you'd see the signs.
Dee dee doo, like scat singing. Verzi had some of that. Somebody played that at Verzi's fucking backyard party. I was just like, this is okay. Jack Johnson's a boxer. Okay, that's not the fucking guy. All right, UFC results. Have you ever heard somebody look up more shit? John Jones got the decision. Oh, Jesus Christ. Over Thiago Santos. I don't know. I don't know anything about it, but that Santos guy was fucking amazing. And I thought John Jones was doing that championship thing where he knows you got to beat the champion to beat him. Just the fact that the fight ended with Jones sort of running away from him. I don't know shit about it, but I was just saying, you can't throw another couple punches. What are we doing here?
I have enough points. Therefore, there's no reason for me to get near him.
Oh, look at this. They got fucking, you guys saw Rogan's fucking reaction.
Nice body kick and a big right from Nunes. Oh, Nunes was... Oh! Huge head kick from Nunes. Amanda Nunes, the queen of the jungle.
It's over.
He did it with a head kick.
It's over.
Just too good. Man.
Oh, that's great. That's great. Do you know Joe Rogan is one of the greatest broadcasters ever? Comedians ever. And he's gonna go into Broadcasting Hall of Fame. There's no fucking way. There's no fucking way. Who else can say they did that? Huh? All right, we're 40 minutes in. Let's get to the fucking questions here.